children, welcome to the history class. What, where, how and when? It is the first chapter in your history test. First, we should know about the word history. History means when the past events are studied carefully and systematically on the basis of available material, remains and records. The person who carries out such studies and records the findings is called a historian. In short, historians are the scholars who study the past. Historians are the scholars who studies the past. In this chapter, we are going to study about what can we know about the past. This is the basic chapter. What can we know about the past? There are several things we can find out. What people ate, the kinds of clothes they wore, the houses in which they lived. We can find out about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craft persons, artists, musicians, and scientists. We can also find out about the games children played, the stories they heard, the place they saw, the song they sung. The history of man has been divided into three periods: ancient, medieval and modern. At the beginning, man did not lead a settled life, but wandered from place to place. He did not know how to read and write. The period of man's existence for which we have no written records. Our next doubt is, where did people live? Earliest people were hunter-gatherers, so they wandered from one place to another and did not have permanent settlements, but mainly wandered along banks of rivers like Narmada. See the map of the subcontinent. Here, Narmada River. Early people began to grow crops like wheat and barley in Sulaiman and Kirtar Hills around 8,000 years ago. See, Kirtar and Sulaiman Hills. And also in Garo Hills. It's the northeast side. Then they started cattle regarding to get meat, wool and skin. Rice was first grown in the north of Vindhyas. Here. Around 5000 years ago, some of the earliest cities flourished along the banks of Indus and its tributaries. It is called Indus Valley Civilization. Around 2500 years ago, cities and civilization developed along the banks of Ganga and its tributaries. This led to rise of Magadha Kingdom at the southern area of Ganga River. The first ruler of Magadha was Brihadratha. He was very powerful king and set up a large kingdom. His son was Bimbisara and the grandson was Ajatashatru. The capital of Magadha was Pataliputra. Now it is Patna, Bihar. The Patna is the capital of Bihar. Next we talk about traveling of people. That time common people traveled all over the subcontinent for livelihood or to escape from droughts, floods or natural disasters. Sometimes men marched in armies conquering other lands. Besides, merchants traveled with caravans or ships carrying valuable goods from one place to another, and religious teachers walked from village to village, town to town, shopping to offer instruction and advice on the way. Finally, some people perhaps traveled driven by a spirit of adventure, wanting to discover new and exciting places. All these led to the sharing of ideas between people. These movements of people enriched our cultural tradition. People have shared new ways to carving stone, composing music, and even cooking food over several hundreds of years. Names of the land. India is derived from the word Sindhu, which is a Sanskrit word. The Iranians and Greeks who came through the northwest about 2500 years ago and were familiar with the Indus called it the Hindos, H-I-N-D-O-S, Hindos, or the Indos, I-N-D-O-S. And the land to the east of the river was called India. And finally, the name Bharata comes from Sanskrit. The name Bharata was used for a group of people who lived in the northwest and who are mentioned in the Rigveda, the earliest composition in Sanskrit, dated to about 3500 years ago. Later, it was used for the country, Bharata.